Tucson police will no longer respond to certain calls, calls like medical welfare checks and runaways.
This revealed in a recent email communication from Police Chief Chris Magnus to the department. News 4 Tucson's Lupita Murillo joins us live with tonight's Digging Deeper report.
Says in the letter here that call demand far exceeds the number of officers available to address it. The president of the FOP for the state of Arizona says that TPD here is no longer in crisis. It's on life support.
For the taxpayers, I would be severely concerned with the level of public safety that you're going to have in your community, in our community.
Sergeant Paul Sheldon is a 20-year veteran of the police department.
It breaks my heart to see us down nearly 400 police officers in a city that has grown considerably over 20 years and continues to grow to this day. And yet there's one department that continues to shrink.
According to Sheldon, the department currently has 765 officers. When he joined, there were 1,100. Over the last 2.5 months, 30 officers have left the department. Currently, 14 recruits are in the 23-week police academy. They will be ready to hit the streets in July. But those 14 recruits won't even begin to make a dent in the 30 positions currently vacant.
You have a lot of people that are retiring because they have done their time there. So we're looking for that new generation, that generation that's growing up, that's coming into the workforce right now.
Public Information Officer Sergeant Richard Gradias is also in charge of recruiting. Another concerning issue from the memo for Sergeant Sheldon is the long list of calls they no longer will be responding to, such as runaways.
We live in a time and age of sexual exploitation of minors, and runaways have a tendency, though some of the reasons they run away is right down that kind of path.
Loud music, loud noise calls.
Loud parties have a history in this city of turning violent, and we're not going, which scares me.
Sergeant Sheldon adds they've stopped responding to traffic accidents, alarm calls, and property crimes.
We just direct you to the website to do your own police report. Like, at some point, somebody's got to say enough is enough and let us get out there and do our job the right way.
Tucson City Councilman Steve Kasajic acknowledges there's a problem.
We've got a critical staffing issue in TPD, and that we need to deal with it. One of the ways we deal with that is with the pay disparity.
Councilman Kasajic says the union also has to do their part.
Everything's got to be on the table. Everybody's got to be willing to sit down at the negotiating table and say, let's find solutions, because this is a very difficult job to hire into, and we don't have a boatload of cash to be dealing with it.
Most of the experienced officers are leaving TPD to go to other police departments for better paying jobs. We wanted to talk to Chief Magnus about it, but we were told that the letter was self-explanatory. You can go to our website, kvoa.com, to read it completely. Digging deeper at TPD headquarters, Lupita Murillo, News for Tucson.